Hi, and welcome to LNA Does Audio Stuff. Hey, today we're gonna look at Meld. First, I'm gonna explain how Meld works with some practical samples. And then I'm gonna show you how I used it in my latest track, Softer Lights. Remember to subscribe so that you support this channel, because maybe in 2024 we can get me to 100,000k followers. So join into my family. Also, I'm an Ableton certified trainer, so I have a full Ableton Live course on my website where you will learn how to make music from start to finish, the whole shebang. So remember to check that out, as well as my Push 2 and Push 3 and live performance courses. Discount codes down below. Let's get going with this tutorial. Okay, so to add Meld into your track, go into the browser window, instruments, and then from there you find Meld. Right now in here I already have a clip that I created a little tune into. Voila, what a masterpiece. Absolute amazing. We're gonna now make that a lot more interesting using Meld. To be able to understand what Meld is all about, I'm also gonna draw you here a little bit of a map, because I'm a visual learner and maybe you are as well. So Meld is structured from basically three pieces. So we have this area here where the sound comes from, so the oscillator area. In the middle we have the envelopes, the LFOs, and the matrix, all these kind of controls how we control the sound. And on the right here we have the global area, which allows us to control the sound all together. So we have 1, 2, and 3. Voila. So here we have A oscillator, and here we have B oscillator. So in Meld, the oscillators are quite simple but very interesting. I think why that is because we're creating most of the interesting sounds in this area here. So the point is that with Meld we can modulate and kind of route everything together in a very interesting way, which is not always possible in all the other instruments. That's why this explanation here is quite necessary. So we have here given a list of options for different shape forms that allow us to create a really interesting synthesis. Example chip. So they determine the character of the sound. So then we have here a tone and the rate. Sometimes the controls are a little bit different, example decay and tone, depending on what kind of oscillation are we getting. Oscillator, I don't always remember how it's written. I'm dyslexic, you don't need to correct me. I will forget it anyway. Because we have two of them, we can connect them together and create already quite interesting sounds. I want something quite soft, so maybe dual basic shapes, and I can use the left and right arrows. We have also tuning options here. We can octave higher, we can go steps higher, or we can do fine tuning as well. Ooh. That's kind of cool. And this one I could go -1, so octave lower. Engines, which is these here, the motional spacing. So with oscillators, with engines, we control oscillation. Also, this video is sponsored by DistroKid. So this year in 2024, I am publishing a track every single month, and it's so easy to do with DistroKid. So as you can see here, I have Overthinker, Curious, Things I Want, Good Choices, Every Time You Want Me. All of those has already been released to all these shops, streaming, social media platforms, and so on. But what's really cool is that you can also do splits in DistroKid quite easily. So splits is basically if you create a track in collaboration with somebody, then you can add the track in here, which track you want to do. And then, so it's a really easy way to add anyone who's collaborated with you into the track so that you all get the money that you deserve. You can add unlimited amount of collaborators. You can also change the splits at any time. So your collaborators do need to create an DistroKid account, but they get minus 50% of their subscription, so that's pretty good. Also, DistroKid never takes a cut from this, so you and your collaborators can keep the 100% of your income from this splitting situation. DistroKid has been kind and given all my followers minus 7% off for your first subscription. So the link is down below, go and check it out. So thank you DistroKid for sponsoring this video. Let's get back into this tutorial. Okay, so now we're gonna go to the middle part, which is the modulation area. Firstly, on the top, we have three tabs. So we have A, B, and settings. Obviously, A and B. We have A oscillator, B oscillator. We are now gonna control the A oscillator's envelope. If we solo only the A oscillator, we can now hear that if we use attack, decay, sustain, and release. Release is the tail of the sound. It makes it really nice and moody. Same thing we can do with the B, so the B oscillator. Okay, we also have an LFO, which is a low frequency oscillator. And what we have here is we have actually LFO 1, LFO 1 FX, and LFO 2. And this is really cool because it allows us a lot of control. So LFO 1 gives us rate, shape, and fold. LFO FX gives us different options here. So we have, example, some cool shapes for the LFO in FX 1 and FX 2. We also have the ramp. So you can see that how with these we can modulate the shape, so we can create really cool things. I'm gonna come back to LFO and envelope in a minute, and I'm gonna demonstrate how does the LFO 1, LFO 1 effect, and LFO 2 work. But we cannot really do that without understanding routing in this instrument. And that's why we have modulation matrix. So matrix, basically, if you wanna see it in a big screen, we need to go here on the left corner, put the arrow up, and we see the whole thing. So on the left top corner, see A and B. So this is the A modulation matrix, and this is the B modulation matrix. And what's really unique about Meld is that usually, example, in wavetable or other instruments, you only have one modulation matrix. But here we actually have A and B oscillators have their own modulation matrices. And we also have a cross modulation. So what does that mean? That means that A, we have here our own matrix. We have B cross matrix. A envelope. And A LFO. So, example, if I want to use the A matrix, I can do it by connecting a LFO to the motion of the oscillator. Motion, so the engine. That means that I'm connecting this one here. LFO 1, and we're going to go into here and we're going to find a motion, so oscillator macro 1. These circles here are called macros, that's why it's oscillator macro 1. And we're going to use this minus 100 and plus 100 scale to see which way we want to go. So example, plus 100 would sound like this. It's quite slow now, so let's put the rate up. With the shape and fold, we can now control how does the LFO 1 control the motion here. Okay, now we can example put, let's put the B up, and we're gonna connect the B envelope, example, into the tone. There we go. So B envelope, and we're gonna do that. And we're going to connect it into the tone. A envelope, so amp envelope, not modulation. So amp, modulation, A envelope, M envelope, A. And we're going to go and find B macro 2. If I do it other way around, it might sound slightly different. So we know now how to connect them. I can also connect the envelope one here or wherever I want to. And this is now getting cool. Now we can basically do cross as well. So we have the B cross modulation matrix here, A here, B modulation, which is here, B LFO. So we're gonna now with the B LFO modulate example, but let's just go and put LFO 1 to LFO 1 rate. No, here. And if I put up here, what does this mean? It means now that this LFO here, the B1, is gonna modulate the rate of this LFO. With this modulation matrix, we can modulate what's in here. And to be honest, almost anything here. And how cool is that? And we can create really cool connections and shapes using that. Just try it out and you'll figure it out. On the top of this, we have also a MIDI matrix here. We can also control MIDI and MPE. So anyone who has MIDI and MPE controllers, this is great for Meld. Also, we have settings, have oscillator key tracking, scale awareness, and glide. Perfect for any kind of control and expression. So on the top of that, we have filters also. And filters is great with modulation matrix as well. If we want to connect, example, LFO into a filter. So we have a list of different type of filters we can choose from. We have the Q and the morph controls. A LFO 1 into the filter frequency. Now we can use the LFO 1 effect to ramp it up. Let's do the same on the B. We can also choose a different shape. And we're gonna put LFO 1 into the filter frequency, which is here. Filter frequency is that there. So I'm connecting this LFO into the filter frequency. Example, we have an interesting sound. But it's taking a little bit too much space. So what we can do is here, we have a mix window next. So next we can use the tone to soften out the tone because it was quite harsh. We can also use the volume to make that a little bit quieter and that one a bit louder. Then we have the global area here, spreading. We have a polyphonic or monophonic option. We have stacking that makes it a lot wider, and we can add some drive as well. So this is my new track, Softer Light. It's my June track because I make a track per month this year. So in this track, the chorus goes like this. This is not mixed version, by the way. And here we have a lift. This was created is that I added some MIDI notes, very long ones, and in here we have Meld. So let's take a phaser and the sidechain compressor away, and you can hear how this sounds. So it's just very noisy. But what's very special about this noise is actually in Meld, you have this rain and bubble option. So it sounds white noise, but it's a rain white noise, which I love. And then on the B, I put filtered noise. On automation, you can see there's quite a lot of automation. I've automated the frequency and the narrow controls, as well as I have automated the filters in both of A and B oscillators. Also on the top of it, I add a phaser flanger to add some cool movement, and then sidechain compression. And it's really wide, soft, organic sounding white noise left. Remember to check out my courses down below if you want to learn more Ableton Live. So I have a playlist full of Ableton Live tutorials like this. Go into here or here to watch more Ableton Live and learn all about it. Also, thank you so much for all my Patreons. Join us if you want to also more accountability and want to be part of the most kindest audio community online. See you next time. Bye bye.